Hi, I'm Dr. Tim Weir, and I gotta tell you, I love life. But when I'm not being a husband, a father, a grandfather, an author, or a practicing chiropractor, I'm the host of the television show Loving Life with Dr. Tim Weir. I love to cook. I love to travel. I like to spend time with people who do what they love and love what they do. Join me and Elvis for the next 30 minutes as we help you discover how to love life. You know, I'm always looking for people who have a great understanding of life and great understanding of how to get you better. And I'm with Greg Sims today. Greg, you're a personal trainer and a guru of
fitness in general.
I love that.
Yeah.
Tell me, because here I am, you know, I'm 32 now and getting older, you know, and so for me, a day-to-day routine, you know, it's an excuse, but I can't fit it in, and you know, all that kind of stuff. What do you recommend for somebody who's needs some help that way?
First thing I would say is, even though it's really hard to fit it in, if you can find the time to fit it in, then you're going to be so much better for it. Your life's going to be more enriched. You'll be able to accomplish more by being able to fit in some type of workout, even if you can only do, say, 15 minutes a day. Then that's where you start. I'll say even 10 minutes a day. If that's what it is, that's what it is.
Wow.
If you can start in the morning, if you're a morning person, then get up, and if you're gonna have coffee, if you're gonna just drink water or juice or whatever it is, get something in you, and then go about some type of movement. If you just wanna walk around the neighborhood, that's an easy way to start in the way of fitness.
Okay.
Because really, walking's the number one exercise when it comes to losing weight. When you compare that to the entire population, if people would just get up and start moving, then they would lose weight. That's why walking becomes the number one exercise. For someone who's already fit, they're gonna have to do a little bit more.
Right.
But to get started, even if you think you can't find the time even for just a few minutes. If it's gonna be a video in your house that you watch, if that's what you feel more comfortable doing, or again, if you can get out and walk, I feel like getting some energy from the sun, being out with people, you know, seeing your neighborhood, seeing what's going on in your neighborhood, and if you don't know your neighbors, kind of getting to know them a little bit by doing this. There's a number of things that it accomplishes by just starting to move. So I'd say, regardless of the time you have, make the time to move.
So starting out with maybe a 20-minute walk?
Sure. I mean, if you can do 20 minutes, because, you know, we're talking about time a little bit, then 20 minutes would be great. If you can do 30, you'll eventually work yourself up to something more, because what will happen is you'll start to feel better, you'll start to see results, you'll sleep better. This is really important, especially when you've had an injury or if you're seeking treatment in any other way. It's good to get your body moving, the blood flowing, and just swinging your arms and swinging your legs. It's amazing what it can do, even for your brain, just to push blood through your body.
It's awesome. I think I can even do that.
I think you can do that.
Okay. Listen, what you want to do is you want to stay with us through the next couple of weeks, because Greg's actually going to share some tips with you on each show. Help you get feeling better. Thanks for being with me today, man.
Glad to be here.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Greg Sims of gregsworkout.com and IFTA, that's Interactive Fitness Trainers of America, based here in Raleigh, North Carolina, but international. What we do for people is help people get fit, help people have a better life, and help people that are wanting to get into the fitness industry to get into it. Now, for you, you might just be wanting to move a little bit or to see some results or some different ideas that you have concerning your body, or just by the way you feel, maybe. So if that's the case, I've got some tips for you. The first thing is, make yourself have a plan to move a little bit each day. If you can, do at least 15 to 20 minutes. If it's just walking, at the very, very basics, if it's just standing and doing this, swinging your arms and lifting your knees, if there's just something that you can do, even in your house as you're watching TV, find your favorite show, something that gets you kind of where you're in a different space and you're able just to not have to worry about a thing, and then start to move. You could also sway side to side. That's something that could happen right there in front of your TV, right there in front of your coffee table. You might want to move it a little bit. You could do some squats. This is really good. Functional things are very important for everyone, no matter what age we are. But as we age, functional things help us to have a better life, to be able to move better, and to be able to conquer anything that comes our way, like say an injury or an illness, something that just hits you out of the blue that you need to do some type of rehab or recovery. If you go to rehab places, you'll see people doing these things, teaching people how to do squats correctly. Notice that I place my hands on my legs. That's called supporting forward flexion. I don't want to talk too much about those kinds of terms. I just want to say, hey, it keeps you from hurting your back as you start to lean forward. So what you would want to do at the very basics of this is sit back with your weight on your heels. Try to make sure that your knees aren't going beyond your toes. I like to think of the visual of your knees in line with your ankles. Hands on your legs again for support. Tighten your abdominals, breathe, never hold your breath, and then sit back and then bring it up. Do as many of those as you can. Go slow if you want to. You can speed it up a little bit if you find this comfortable. The thing about it is, it works the large muscle groups, which is right here. And the definition of aerobics is to move those large muscle groups rhythmically over an extended period of time. So we could use it as muscle conditioning for the hamstrings, the glutes, all throughout here as we tighten the abdominals, or we could use it for a little bit of cardio at the same time. So as you see, it's kind of busy around us. Doesn't matter. We're here to help you. Little things that you can do. Also, lean over and stretch. This is going to help, but notice that I'm supporting what is called lateral flexion. That means holding your hand right here and making sure that your back is okay with moving that way. Simple little things that you can do. We'll go over more in the next few segments that we do. We'll go over some different exercises and some better stretches, perhaps, that might reach right into where you need them to reach. But thanks for joining me. I'm Greg Sims, gregsworkout.com.
We're talking about relaxing, having a relaxed moment. Sometimes I like to just come to a park where it's gorgeous here in Raleigh. The trees are beautiful. There's flowers, everything around. And you just look around and you just look at things. You know, sometimes we get so busy in life we don't look at things. Just look at things and realize that the guy that put this all together, the creator of everything, is creating your life. And guess what you can do? You can just relax in that. It's an awesome time to spend time with you. We get so busy all this time with other people. We got to be with so-and-so or with such-and-such, or we got to be on the job and we're with our coworkers. Sometimes we got to spend time with the most important person, and that's ourselves. If you don't like spending time with yourself, you can have problems with relationships in other areas too. So learn to love yourself. Bible says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. So if you don't love yourself, it's hard to love your neighbor. So get quiet, get alone, go to a park. Just enjoy yourself. Love yourself. You're a pretty good person to love. Hey, you've heard me talking before about creating. Getting around your house, getting in your backyard, creating. Remember, I put together a pond of my own, a koi pond. And now I want to take it a little bit further and maybe spice it up just a little bit and maybe change it. So I'm with Sandy Mazzella from Advanced Landscaping and Lawn Care. Sandy, thank you for being with me today.
Thank you for having me.
So as you can see, I just kind of put together this one, like maybe 3 weekends it took me to do this. But I want to make it a little bit bigger and better.
Right.
So before we even talk about that, these things are incredible for helping people relax, aren't they?
Correct.
Now, when you have people call you, you just take over the whole project usually, is that right?
That is correct.
Okay. So can people do it on their own?
Sure they can.
What's the pitfalls to that?
Might not have a correct ecosystem, might not have biofalls in there correctly, might not have the proper pH. Construction is important, pond liner is important, how we form the rocks is important. The whole system is just very crucial.
So, because I've been to yours and it's incredible. How many fish do you have in there right now?
About 2 to 2.5 dozen.
Man, it is just gorgeous. And of course, that's what got me excited about having you come over, because I've seen your work
right.
and what you do. So as you look at mine here, you know, I didn't know what I was doing. I just picked up a book of some kind, just started digging and doing all that kind of stuff. We had talked a little bit earlier about the amount of flow that's coming down here.
Yes.
Is that one of the first things that you would change here?
I would definitely consider changing the flow by adding a stronger pump, maybe a 2,000-gallon pump.
Okay.
I would perhaps consider widening the rocks here to create more of a powerful waterfall.
Yeah.
I would probably create a little bit bigger of a hole and a little bit deeper of a hole.
You're talking about the waterfall. One of the nicest things about this thing is sitting out here in the porch or wherever we're at, maybe with a cup of coffee or tea, and listening to it.
Yes.
It's really relaxing.
Absolutely.
It's got to do nothing but lower your blood pressure. Just make you. I think it's a great way to start your day.
Absolutely.
So widening it, we just move the rocks out. Is that right?
Yes.
Just kind of spread them out?
Move the rocks out and maybe put them back a little bit differently.
Yeah, because there's a liner in here that actually comes out about here, I think, and then the rocks cover up that rubber liner.
Yes.
And you can actually see some of that liner there where some of the rocks have been moved. Okay, so we're going to widen this a little bit, and then you talk about coming out here and making maybe another stream out here?
Yes, I was thinking about keeping the stream that you have but making it a little wider. And then perhaps channeling another stream off to the side of this so you'd have two streams, and then create that stream into another pool, another little pond, and have it all as one pond.
Okay. It sounds like a lot of work, but...
It's probably half a day's work.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. So then we would dig this down here and then come down in here. We can keep this tree?
Yes, we can keep this tree. We can take this new creation here, we can keep this tree, and we can work this whole area into the same pond you have and create just one big pond, or perhaps another fall as well.
Oh, and then how would fish couldn't come up here then?
Well, we would probably dig this deep enough so that they can join and be as one.
Okay.
So fish could come in here and go in there and perhaps have this area a little bit deeper than that area.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
Of course, the earth will dictate how far down we can,
exactly.
we can actually dig.
Okay. Now, we were working on a project, and I was just trying to get out here and work out some energy, so I actually dug that by hand. Feel those muscles there, they're incredible. But what you're saying is that we could actually get a machine out here and dig it a little bit.
Probably a machine. The ground might be a little too difficult to continue digging any further down without a machine.
Is it one of those big earth movers that would they do highways? Just kidding. So we'll just kind of connect this, because then it gives the fish a little bit more room to move and all that kind of stuff.
Yes.
Change that pump out.
Change that pump out to a stronger pump so we have more of a flow. Also, the more gallons per minute will allow you to have more fish as well.
Now, you know, when people look at something like this, they think that the cost must just be terrible. But for me to put all this in, it really was not that expensive, but I did all the work myself.
Right.
But when you see stuff like this, don't let the cost, you know, you think it's going to prohibit you from doing it, because you can get deals everywhere and work something out. You can call Sandy up, let him come out and take a look at your yard if this is something that you want to do. But you do all kinds of landscape stuff, too. It's not just ponds that you do.
That is correct. We do all phases of landscaping and all phases of lawn care.
And fireplaces.
Fireplaces, so we create them as well against your patio or actually with your pond. So
really?
You can enjoy a fireplace with your pond as well.
It is really cool in the fall to sit out there and build a fire.
Absolutely.
Roast some marshmallows.
That's...
All right. So we're going to get going on this probably over the next couple of weeks. And you can kind of watch me and see how we do it and try to figure out how you can do it yourself. Sandy, it was great having you here today, man.
Thank you.
We're going to work on this together.
Absolutely.
You and me.
Thank you for having me.
Good to have you here. Hey, we're in Durham, North Carolina at a place called Foster's Market. This is actually Sarah Foster's restaurant. Great chef. She's actually with Martha Stewart, but she couldn't be here today with us, so we're talking to Matt and Callie. Hey, guys.
Hey, how you
Sir. Doing? Welcome to Foster's.
Thanks for letting us come.
Thank you for coming.
I am amazed because I've never heard of this before, and you guys have been here 25 years.
This is our 25th year of business.
That is amazing.
It's great.
So if you could give me some of your top things people like to eat here.
Well, it's actually an exciting time at the market because we just switched the menu. We've introduced quite a few new breakfast items as well as some new sandwiches. And, you know, we have people that have been coming to the restaurant, obviously, for years. So, you know, they're excited to try a lot of the new favorites. We have a barbecue turkey sandwich now. It's on the menu. It's really popular. We do a meatloaf sandwich. It's also really popular.
I love meatloaf sandwiches.
Yeah, it's good stuff. And you can get it hot or cold. So we kind of
really?
please both sides of that fight, so to speak, you know.
What's your favorite thing?
My favorite is probably the Grilled Turkey Club, which is a classic, but I love it. It's got really great focaccia bread and brie and bacon and turkey. It's phenomenal.
Now, I've heard the seven pepper jelly thing a couple of times here.
Mm-hmm.
What is it?
So Sarah Foster makes her own seven pepper jelly. It's a jelly consistency with different peppers in it. And we actually have a sandwich here that has two sandwiches now.
Yeah.
We have the jam and turkey breast, which is phenomenal with the seven pepper jelly and red onions and turkey. And so, then we also have a grilled seven pepper jelly.
Is it how you say in America, really hot?
It's not too bad. It's got a kick to it, but it's not too bad. Yeah.
Well, that is awesome.
The grilled cheese sandwich and the seven pepper jelly is where it's at, though. If you haven't had seven pepper jelly before, it's a good way to get introduced to it. It's pretty darn good.
So when you're in Durham, you got to come to this place. We'll show you around, but it is just awesome. And you know, I love good food, and the atmosphere is just really cool here.
It is, and it kind of translates to the food too. You know, everything's really casual. You know, we don't try and take ourselves too seriously. You know,
I love that.
Yeah, you know, it's just life. You know, it's Southern comfort. You know, and that's kind of the whole kick to it.
Cool. So can we look? We're gonna try some food.
Oh yeah,
okay?
I got some stuff coming for you.
And you got Matt's muffin.
How can I not?
You know? Named after Matt. All right, so we're gonna take a look around. Just enjoy yourself. We're gonna have a blast. Okay, so we got some food here to try. This is the French bread that's made with...
Yeah, we actually, this is the Lucas's cinnamon vanilla French toast. We actually make trays of bread pudding, and then when we cool it down, we slice it into what you see here, and then we batter it and cook it up on our flat top. It's really really dense, really rich.
It's kind of like
really
a sin.
Sweet. Kind of, yeah. I mean, it's, you know, it's not something you might want to eat for breakfast every... Well, you probably wanted to eat it for breakfast every day, but you probably shouldn't. You know?
Yeah.
I'm not one to judge, so have at it.
And this is just...
Yeah, this is just our regular breakfast biscuit. Just some nice, fresh, local scrambled eggs. We work with a chicken farm that's right in the area. We buy eggs from them just about every day. And one of our homemade biscuits.
And this is...
This is the piece de resistance. It's the Matt Muffin. It's named after me. We kind of threw it together as a brunch special. We do brunch on the weekends. You know, we serve a chef special, we serve a pancake special. We go a little bit further into the breakfast menu than we normally do. That's just something that we ran for a special and kind of stuck. People liked it, and now it's on the menu. you can't really pick it up and eat it all in one shot, you know?
I'm just gonna cut it like this.
Yeah, it's kind of the best way to attack it.
Make sure to get some of that spinach with the sausage, it's
phenomenal.
It's right,
oh man.
You definitely won't leave Foster's hungry, that's for sure.
Wow. We'll come back to that.
Yeah, this one you gotta try. This has been really popular since we added it to the menu also. Wait for it.
That is good.
Does it every time.
Wow. One more thing, I gotta try this.
Yep. That one's kind of
And you know, like this, you can't just
Yeah, they're two-fisters.
There's no way to do this. They're
definitely two-fisters. We're not about being being prim and proper, you know what I mean? You gotta get next to eat good breakfast.
Crossford Market, you gotta come here. This is unbelievable. Stay tuned, we'll be right back.